Good morning, and welcome to the fourth annual Ending Age-Related Diseases Conference, and I hope you all are healthy and well. Thank you for joining us online again this year, coming together to share your knowledge and experience, be it as a researcher, investor, journalist, or advocate, during this pivotal time for our field of geroscience and the world. We have an excellent program over the next few days filled with talks, interviews, and panels from inspiring thought leaders in our industry and designed to foster collaboration between us all in the fight to overcome age-related disease. And our team is ready to assist if you need help navigating this conference platform or networking with each other throughout the event. And on that subject, I'd like to recognize our staff and board at Lifespan.io, especially the conference organizers, Elena Malova and Denise Barker, and our dedicated volunteers. I'd also like to thank our conference sponsors and media partners for helping to make this event possible, and whom I encourage you to learn more about and interact with by visiting their sponsor pages in this platform or clicking their logos on our webpage at lifespan.io/conference. And of course, I'd like to thank our donors and heroes who support us at lifespan.io/hero, including many of you who are here today. Thank you. Behold Gilgamesh, the first literary epic hero, on a quest to heal the frail and the sick by finding the flower of rejuvenation. The very first hero's journey, of which we're all still a part. Now, thousands of years later, it's no secret that it's been quite the year since our third annual conference. The world's been dealt a grievous blow, is still being dealt a grievous blow. But in this crisis lies an opportunity to build a better future, one more protected against age-related diseases, of which the pandemic is one amongst many. Thankfully, it's also no secret that our field is accelerating rapidly, perhaps fomented by this new world we find ourselves in. Traditional boundaries are crumbling, everyone on Zoom, and it seems like not a day goes by that I don't hear of some new organization emerging to join those existing in addressing the issues of an aging population head on. New technologies are emerging as well, such as blockchain, and new communities with them, joining with ours to help resolve long-standing infrastructure and funding bottlenecks in our field. As powerfully evinced by the recent Pulse Chain cryptocurrency fundraiser to support the SENS Research Foundation, which raised nearly $28 million from an almost entirely new cohort of donors. Now, one data point that might seem to counter this narrative of growing public support is this survey you might have seen from a few months ago, which was interpreted by the press as only one-third of Americans being open to life extension therapies. But a closer look at the actual questions asked by the investigators reveal that the chosen framing has little to do with the realities of our field, and likely in no way undercuts the trends of growing public perception we discussed last year, and previous results which show when questions are framed with preserved health in mind, the results are much more favorable. In fact, it's only become clearer this year that our work is reaching beyond our traditional research silos and echo chambers. Prominent advocates of our field are appearing ever more frequently on popular news shows and podcasts and writing compelling books on aging. And channels specifically focused on geroscience are rising quickly, engaging new segments of the public every day. Even in mainstream pop culture, the ideas of age-related disease and regenerative medicine have taken center stage. For example, in the recent release of M. Night Shyamalan's new movie Old, which, no spoilers, focuses squarely on aging and has some strong things to say about the current pace of medical research. And also Marvel's Falcon and the Winter Soldier earlier this year, the plot of which not only centers on a serum with health-extending properties, but on the issues of equitable access to life-saving therapies generally. And at the personal level, I'm busier now than I can ever remember. Constant emails, meetings, and conferences. I have a feeling many of you can relate. But this is a good thing. An amazing thing, actually. Because with this attention comes increasing investment and philanthropy, driving us forward. And this in turn continues to bear meaningful fruit, both in terms of improvements to core biological tools such as CRISPR and age-related technologies such as cellular reprogramming and senescent cell clearance. At Lifespan.io, we are both benefiting from and adding to this rising tide as well, most recently through our successful crowdfunding of the Pearl Project with AgelessRx, which will evaluate various dosing regimens of the medicine rapamycin and test if its known immune system promoting and life-extending effects on other mammals can translate safely to humans, a question our community has wanted a definitive answer to for quite some time. and which has new relevance in the current global circumstances. We are also continuing to engage a growing percentage of the public in our work, both through our flagship news outlet and through the production of high-quality video content such as our weekly Lifespan news show and our more wide-reaching show, Science to Save the World, which allows us to respond to pop culture events such as the M. Night Shyamalan movie Old mentioned earlier and educate entirely new audiences. And this year, we're going even further by working on a documentary series for PBS on aging. More collaborations with YouTube celebrities, like those we've created with amazing channels like Kors Gazakht and Lifenagen, and fiscally sponsoring the creation of a feature-length adaptation of Tim Maupin's award-winning and excellent short film, The Last Generation to Die, designed to captivate the public not only intellectually, but emotionally. I'm proud to say we've helped advise on the script of this important project, and if you are interested in seeing such a movie exist, through investment or philanthropy, please contact Tim at timmaupin@lifespan.io. On the research side, our Longevity Investor Network continues to expand and promote investment into early-stage longevity companies, meeting monthly to hear pitches from promising projects and teams. And I'm excited to share that one of the public benefit corporations we have supported since its inception and have an interest in, Novos, has just closed a VC-backed financing round that they will be officially announcing next week to build out its platform of research-backed nutraceuticals that address all hallmarks of aging simultaneously and both online and offline biomarker tests. We are also, thanks to our heroes helping us attain our latest campaign goal, going to be starting in-house research projects led by our very own Dr. Oliver Medvedik, focused on leveraging our strengths in crowdsourcing to investigate promising non-pharmacological interventions for age-related disease, which lack traditional profit motives. One technology which may aid these endeavors greatly, which I want to highlight, is blockchain. While most of you may be familiar with this in terms of cryptocurrency, the underlying architecture of Web 3.0 and capabilities of blockchain, decentralization, permissioned access to data, and privacy-preserving transactions have the ability to help resolve long-standing problems with healthcare data use and interoperability, empowering both crowdfunding and crowdsourcing. And when paired with other advancing technologies such as machine learning, can facilitate the creation of powerful biomarkers and predictors of disease, which could help us both shut down global pandemics and understand what affects our individual rates of aging. Indeed, I am excited to see what the future holds for Lifespan. But no matter what we do, none of us can meet the enormity of this task alone. Over 100,000 people die every day due to the diseases of aging. One person every second, and ticking faster every day. Someone's daughter or son, your mother or father, one day you. Now, more than ever, the world is beginning to understand that our fates are intertwined. And important work such as the paper this year by David Sinclair, Andrew Scott, and Martin Ellison allow us to more strongly make the socioeconomic case for addressing the root causes of aging, if the moral reasons are somehow not enough. Armed with data such as this, the concept of the longevity dividend, the fruition of which, once so distant, is coming into focus to meet our ever-pressing needs as a society for sustainable and equitable health for all people. This now undeniable value proposition is waking up governmental organizations as well, including in the United States, where the National Institute on Aging is now funding trials for interventions that directly affect the root causes of age-related disease and have multiple chronic conditions as endpoints instead of only one disease. And the current administration proposing the establishment of the ARPA-H or HARPA initiative in 2022 with a requested annual funding level of $6.5 billion focused directly on supporting high-impact biomedical breakthroughs specifically targeting Alzheimer's and cancer. To capitalize on this momentum and help ensure that such initiatives can have the maximum effect possible, I'm happy to remark on one more recent development: the emergence of the Alliance for Longevity Initiatives, the first and only 501c4 organization founded with the express goal of creating social and political action towards addressing the issues of an aging population by addressing aging itself. The existence of such an organization, which has unique capabilities which 501c3s do not, has been a long-time need of our field, and I am proud to be a part of it myself. And that LEAF will be serving as its fiscal sponsor, allowing it to receive philanthropic support for on-mission activities. But once again, I wish to stress that no individual person or organization can meet this challenge alone. The circumstances which have led us to be gathered here today in this manner have perhaps given us new opportunities, yes, but I refuse to think of those dying right now to the pandemic and other age-related diseases as necessary sacrifices. We have the power to help people right now on the way to and part of helping those in the future. And as our work to end age-related diseases finally begins to draw the attention and support of which it is truly worthy, we too must become worthy by being greater than the sum of our parts, by sharing our knowledge, holding each other accountable, healing each other and ourselves so as to better heal the world. When Gilgamesh strode beyond the great walls of the city Uruk to overcome the diseases of aging, he did so selfishly. It was only when he returned after many years that, changed by the journey, he sought to bring the gifts of healing to all humanity. Our field of geroscience, once so small, is poised to explode, and we're set to go on quite the journey. It is my wish that while we're on it, we learn the lesson Gilgamesh did. And as the attention, money, and opportunities flow, that we continue to work together. Future generations have their eyes on us, and we must work not just in our own interests, but for the interest of all humankind. And in that spirit, I welcome you to Ending Age-Related Diseases 2021. I hope you have a wonderful conference. Thank you.